Hello and welcome back to Let's Play the Darkside Detective Blind. I'm the RPG chick, now entering the second case file, Tome Alone. Dooley suggested a visit to the library. He must have seen the strange storm gathering over it. I'm really enjoying this so far. Tome Alone. Ooh. Now it's raining. It was funny, he said it was raining in the first episode, but it wasn't. And now it is. Detective McQueen says, okay, what's the case, Dooley? Fill me in. Case? No, I have some overdue books to drop back. So, that purple swirling vortex thing above the building has nothing to do with why we're here? It reminds me of the first Ghostbusters with the haunted library or the apparition in the library. Ah, come on now, Detective. You're hardly going to arrest the weather. The things you'll try to do to justify this department. Let's get this over with. We'll be done in a jiffy, Detective. Statue, okay. Zool? These statues make me uncomfortable. They're not very welcoming. They should at least be wearing a book or reading a book or wearing glasses or something. Before this was the library, it was where the mayor kept her lion collection. Oh, right. That clears that up, so. Same. How many cases do we need to solve, do you think, to get a car that doesn't leak in the rain? It keeps us fresh. Sharp, even. Plaque. This is a library. What a helpful plaque. It really says this is a library. Okay. Let's get out of this rain. Fines? For being late? How are books late? It's not like they have places to be. You're not charming your way out of this, Patrick. Rules are rules. Librarian Doris. Can we come to some kind of arrangement? Do you have any parking tickets you want to see go bye-bye? Dooley, are you trying to bribe your way out of a fine? No? Here's an arrangement for you. I'll drop your fines if you arrest that troublesome kid. Kid? The one who's responsible for the storm. And, you know, the ghosts. Ghosts? What? Whee! Flickering lights. These brownouts seem like they'd make for frustrating reading conditions. I thought you found owning books suspicious. It is. What kind of secret stuff are you reading that you can't get it from your local library? Maybe some people just like having their own books? Maybe it's a germ issue. Germs? You really will believe in anything Hollywood tells you. From a certain angle, this looks like a silly sideshow clown here. A silent shh! Is this your to-read pile? Oh, I've read all those. The desk is missing a leg, so I'm using them to balance out the computer. Okay. I guess we'll talk to the librarian. What were you saying about ghosts? The place is haunted. You know, the usual stuff. The usual? Flickering lights, floating books, strange noises, eerie purple storms. It's chasing off the readers. And you say a kid is to blame? He's the only one here often enough. Suspiciously often, if you ask me. I'll look into it. Do, or else I'll call a pair of oddball priests and or a questionable ghost-busting startup to come fix this. Yep, there's your reference. What books did Dooley borrow? He had Rules to Rave To, Roswell, New Mexico, where the aliens really experiment on us, and The Law, What Is It, and Do We Really Need It? Nice. Hey, what happened to librarian reader privilege? Not a real thing, buddy. I take it you gave up on the law book? Not enough pictures. What's that you're reading? Guylight, the heartbreaking tale of a girl who falls in love with a reverse vampire. Of a what now? A reverse vampire. He can only come out during the day. Really? Does someone else suck his blood? I'm at the part where it's her prom night and he promised to take her, but the clocks went forward and now it's on at night. What happens if he goes out at night? He gets really sleepy. Sounds interesting. What? It sounds awful, Detective, Dooley says. If you need anything else, I'll be here. Unless I'm not. Alright. Should we check the office first before we start going up flights of stuff? I forgot to restart my little timer here. Alright, we've got stuff in here, like a calendar. I got this for Doris last time I had to get out of paying fees. I'm gonna have to up the ante this time. Guylight. Photocopier? An old photocopier? I can't imagine this gets much use. Oh, it does. When you renew your card each year, Doris takes a photocopy of your butt for the records. Everyone's butt? Just mine, now that I think of it. That's the price of working out, I guess. Really? Coat rack. Looks like some of these coats have been here for years. We should go through their pockets. You know, for evidence. Okay, well, we received a button. A button from an old coat. Great evidence, Dooley. I'd rather try something else first. Trash bin. Roses are red, violets are blue. Your loaning rights are revoked due to books overdue. I really enjoy the access to secret areas this job gets us. Staff only? Not on our watch. Never know when I'll need to cut something in half. Or a lazy approximation of half. Okay, we took the scissors. Scissors. Safe for cutting? Not safe for running with. I've got a computer. Look at that last. There's nothing else here I can see myself needing. Lamp? Even the lamp is flickering. What a disappointing haul. Alright. Let's call that Plan B. Would you like some scissors? Come on, Frankie, you can do better than that. Okay, let's look at the computer. The computer seems to be broken. It's not broken. It's hollow. So they can store more books in it. What? Cut up the calendar? No. Cut up the coats. Put a button back on the coat. Put a button on the lamp. Alright. I think we're done in here then for now. Anyway. You want to photocopy the scissors? No? I have a feeling we're going to need this photocopier for something. You want some scissors? How about a button? Okay. Going up then. An old elevator? Where is the staircase? We have none. There was a fire, and ironically, the fire escape was the only thing that was destroyed. Okay, horror is out. Broken button. The button for the fourth floor is missing. Tetraphobia. Tetraphobia? Fear of the number four. It's quite common for buildings in China to be missing the fourth floor. But the fourth floor is there, just the button is missing. Oh yeah. And we're not in China. You have all the answers, don't you? Alright, I'm guessing that will go there before, but we came from reception. I just want to see everything else first before I start messing with that. Sci-fi and fantasy children? Or sci-fi and fantasy and children? What odd leaves that plant has. That? That's just a dead tree where Doris dries her stockings. What did the rabbi and the priest talk about in the library? I don't know. Nothing. Libraries are a place of quiet, respect, and solitude, which they were both respecting. Okay. You need to work on your stand-up material. So I find fantasy that way. Statue. Don't blink! Doctor Who reference, the children's section is that way. Alright, let's go to the children's section. Is this the kid? Little Devin? What about this one? The words are short, and I think I can read the whole book from one cover to the other cover. Who is not saying something? Oh, is that suitable for my age range? I read a book about books for my age range, and they're all books about boys and wizards and talking dogs. Okay, I'll try it. I hope I like it, because I've read the books... I've read all the books about boys and wizards and talking dogs in here. Okay, let's look around before we talk to him. Letters. A, B, C. As easy as 1, 4, 5, 6. We got a floating book. Well, that's not right. Neat trick. What magic book did you learn that from, kid? It's not magic, it's... nothing. Robot? I hope I get to have a pet robot someday. Too many responsibilities. Feeding it, rubbing its belly, teaching it to overthrow humanity. Why would you teach it that? I want it to be on their good side when the inevitable happens. I've always loved trains and trams. Not monorails, though. Thinking they're better than everyone because they're high up in the air. Nobody, not one person, needs kids to be talking like there are so many invisible with them. Why your parents don't love you. Anne and Barry face financial ruin. Little and Big Pooh save the day. Maybe it is your fault. Are these random? It is really random. I'm clicking the same spot. Little Billy and the Crushed Dreams. The baby's first hangover. Yeah, it's repeating. There's Little Devin's over there. You look familiar. Have I arrested you before? Viewmaster. A Viewmaster! I loved those as a kid. I'll take this and see if I can find a use. It's times like these I miss walking the beat. Blink! I received the Viewmaster. An old film viewing toy. Dinosaur. The dust is wrong under this. Makes me think it was moved recently. Bad baby incites a riot. Kindergarten Kate summons the devil. Grumpy Chris hates to play. Learn to count to 107, the largest number known to science. What? A guide to baby safe shots. Daddy's little disappointment. Aww. Repeating over, you're pulling the string. Alright, let's talk to Little Devin. Who are you talking to, kid? I'm not telling you anything. I've heard what happens to people who do a snitch. Modern media is really making our job hard. Alright, that was not much. You like this Viewmaster? Come on, Frankie. Cut the kid, cut the kid. Alright. Oh, I didn't look at this vent. There's a cold draft coming from the vent. That can't be good for this kid's health. Anything else to look at? Let's cut up this teddy. No. Alright, let's go back. How about the sci-fi and fantasy? Oh, cool. If we lived in medieval times, we'd be living the adventures of your Darkside Bailiff and his Squire Dooley. I never understood this section. How can something be fiction and science? don't know what to do with you sometimes. Get me a raise? Rocket. I wanted to be an astronaut when I was younger, until I found out that they had to go into space. Looks like some of the rocket's aluminum is coming off. That could be useful. Metal strip. That could be useful. A small amount of aluminum metal. Alright, more books. Fantastic Obit, drowned in moonlight, strangled by her own bra. Doctor Whom's thrilling adventures through grammar and structure. Space hike, boldly going to places safely explored by others. How to woo a Wookiee. Mass defect, get it? They came from space. They were brains. Brains from space. Space brains. Blasters, 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 and other space weapons. Intergalactic ballistics for cats. Astro trolls. Alright, repeating. Yeah. Library card. How convenient. I'd have expected to go through a series of semi-logical puzzles to get this. I received an old library card. The library card of one smug-faced Paul Conway. Cut it up. No. Look at through the Viewmaster. Put aluminum on it. Put a button on it. Okay. Chessboard. I like these magnetic chess sets. I don't think those pieces are magnetic. Sure, how else would they be moving, Detective? That is a good question. Alright. Nothing else to do in here? Oh wait, there's more books. On this side, let me read them. The titles, anyway. Glum Tales of the Sad Venturer. The Library of Books. Okay. Dragon Ageism. The Witcher, Tales of an Indecisive Adventurer. Fantastic Geese and Where to Find Them. They were done. Alright. Let's see if this kid has anything to say about this card. Okay. Alright, we're done in here. Let's go up to floor 3. Reading room and hobby. Hobby, DIY, reading room. Professor Theodore Library, inventor of the library. Seriously? Nope, not one word of that is true. Do you have one brown coat you wear all the time, or a wardrobe full of the same style? We'll have to just wonder about that one. Let's go to the hobby DIY section. A mannequin. He looks like he's jumping. You jump too if somebody shoved a pole up your behind. I don't know why I clicked that again. Wait a minute. These are printouts of a children's art. Look at Mr. Moneybags in his deep pockets. Rich enough that he can pay child artists for original works, this guy. Jeez. Oh, same. Pots and brushes. Why are these fake? Well, you can't have kids painting all over the books. Somebody seems to have left some glue here. It's no duct tape, but it could be useful. I got glue! A tube of hobby glue. Let's add it to the metal strip. Nope. Let's add it to the library card. I feel like I'm back in kindergarten art class. Okay, I made a sticky library card randomly. Why did I do that again? Exactly. I put on aluminum? No. You master. Go artsy craftsy? No. Put a button on it? No. Okay. Hobby books. So the only thing left is books to look at. Turning duct tape into pants. Make your nethers sustainable. Huh? Things you can fill jam jars with. Volume 3. Whittling dice out of larger dice. Detective. The inspectioning, investigative, role-playing in the world of Darkside. Hardwood and where to find it. Okay. DIY books? How to DIY yourself. I'm really good at DIY. I got my sister to do it for me. What? This one's called Building Mediocre Mysteries by the Spooky Doorway Team, whoever they are. DIY because you're too broke to pay someone else to do it. So Your Government is Broken by C. Guevara. The Definitive Guide to Landscaping, from Outside to Downstairs. I don't see why we're sticking around here, Detective. You couldn't wait until I picked up the glue to say that, no? Sometimes I feel like you don't see me as anything more than a ha-ha sidekick. Alright, let's go. On to the reading room. Oh, hello, miss. I wasn't expecting anyone to be here. Raxa. Oh, hello. My name's Raxa. I'm here to study the strange goings-on. I guess that's why you're here too, Detective? Sure, that's me. Always investigating stuff. On purpose. Want to share what you found? Well, it's not much, but there seems to be a strange concentration of energy in the next room. I'm searching the internet for a way to be able to see whatever it actually is. Well, let me know if you find anything. Next room is the microfilm room. You look uncomfortable, Dooley. It's this whole reading room thing. I mean, should we be reading right now? Can I not read anywhere else? Does the room itself read? And if so, what does it read? You have a special mind, Dooley. Chief Scully says that's why she assigned me to your department. Great. Chalkboard. Who doesn't need chalk in the 21st century? Most people? A fair point. Can I get any of this chalk? No. Rax's books. I hope there's nothing contraband in this pile. I wish. You know what I mean. Time always seems to stand still in boring places like libraries. Alright, so there's nothing else to look at. Talk to Raxa. So, ghost hunting a detective? That's classic. Yeah, because there's a whole bunch of eerie mumbo-jumbo going on here. So you noticed then. I'm majoring in the occult at TLU. You can do that? I thought all that stuff was banned. Somebody has to catalog and ban it all, detective. Right. It's all fairly hush-hush. So what does one study with occultism? Whatever you want. I went with computer science so I wouldn't be studying two impractical subjects. Good call, Raxa. From your experience, I can tell you that the occult doesn't pay much. You want a sticky library card? You want a metal strip? How about a Viewmaster? How about some scissors? Would you like a button? Alright, let's go in the microfilm room. Do you think there is such a thing as megafilm? What? Why would anyone have so many filings that they need a cabinet to store them in? Microfilm reader. It's broken. If I want to look at any microfilm, I'll need to find another way to do so. Like with the Viewmaster. It's radiating energy, like Raxa said. I think that may be a clue, possibly. There's just too much here to take. Even my pockets have their limits. Well, let's just put that aside for a second. The computer. Let's see what we can find online. You didn't say the magic word. Looks like I need to figure out the password. Let's use the view finder on the box of microfilm. The film is too big. It's a square peg, round hole situation. Oh. Can I cut up the film first? Well, I've destroyed some historical material. Let's hope there was a point to this. Even cut up, it's too much to carry. Looks like I need to bring something here, like the Viewmaster. Well, it fits. Let's look at what I didn't accidentally chop out of Twin Lakes' recent history. Spider moths, do it again. Do it again. Sounds like they were on some kind of winning streak, instead of having burnt down yet another stadium. I like the sound. Major staff cuts at City Library. Budgetary cutbacks have seen the local library reduced to a skeleton staff. Get it? I know Doris is old, but that seems a bit unfair. It means very few people work here. Oh, yep. Just Doris now, and she's actually a retired volunteer. Tough times. Computer stock goes up, up, down, down, left, right, BA. Okay. That's the boss battle. I shouldn't have read that aloud. I think I may have just summoned something. Crackpot detective claims teenager's tags were a ritual meant to show the dead that walk among us. Okay. I remember this case. What the? Detective McQueen. Hello? Who are you and how did you get here? Aleister Crowley. I am that which can never be unseen. The ooze from your nightmares. The knower of the unknown. Right. That's not very helpful, if I'm honest. Help is there for those that know how to take it. Okay then, I'll bite. Tell me, oh knower of the unknown, what's going on here?
I don't rightly know.
Right.
But I do know that the coward Yeats is protecting a hidden room, one that holds vast power and treasures. No doubt that which is responsible for the spectral summoning of myself and the others lies within.
The others?
The others.
Detective, who are you talking to? I'm talking to... You know what? I don't even know how to explain this. Why are you holding that viewmaster? And who are you talking to? Actually, we both know what's best if you don't try and explain. As you were, Detective Nutjob. Thanks. What was all that again?
Yeats, secret room, mad power within. We cool, bro?
We're cool. Here, have a metal strip. Would you like this old library card? What if we used the library card in the microfilm reader? What if we used the library card in the computer? No. This box of microfilm has gotten me into enough trouble for one day, thanks very much. It's still broken, but thankfully I don't need it now. Alright, Yeats, big power stuff. Oh, another ghostie! Oh, there's Yeats. Why are you wearing a Viewmaster, Detective? Oh, it's part of the game I'm playing. The game also involves me pretending to talk to invisible people. No need for further questions. Everything has been answered satisfactorily. Goodbye. Okay. So this reminds me of, Fatal Frame? If you look... I think you look through the camera and you see the ghosts, and you can take a picture of them. Now, this is not a camera, though. So here's Yeats. Hold on a second, I need a drink. Actually, let's see what Dooley has to say. You look uncomfortable, Dooley. I'm still not loving your Viewmaster goggles vibe.
Pray, sir, a moment of your time. W.B. Yeats.
Another one?
Another spirit. Yes, then with your question you have answered my own.
Huh?
Forgive me, but I wish to know if you have seen, on your travels, that scoundrel Crowley.
Forcefully mysterious man in the silly hat?
The very same. I knew he lurked here, but somewhere.
He mentioned a hidden room?
Yes, but on the matter I shall say no more. Not until a beast is gone.
But I just want it. Not a word more, sir. Not a word more.
Again I say that you and I, sir, shall not converse until Crowley lurks, awaiting a slip of my tongue.
Oh, while he lurks, awaiting a slip of my tongue, yeah. Have you seen this library card? You want strip of symptoms? Okay, never mind. Alright, let's go. There's another ghostie. Gale. Are you an author too? I don't recognize you. Aye, but not like yon toffs with their literary fiction. I wrote useful things, like house wiring and how to do own plumbing. Think you could fix the elevator? With right gear I could aye. I'd need a new button, mind. I have a button for you. See if she'd rather take this. I want to look around first before I do anything, though. Are there any ghosts here? Anyone in the office? No? Can I make a copy of this card? No. How about a copy of a metal strip? Alright. Your elevator is broken. There's no button for the fourth floor. Yep. I hope you don't want to read any horror books. Well, I would like to be able to go there. Oh, well then. Sorry, I guess. Can I have the internet password, please? And give you access to all my juicy manuscripts? No chance. Doris, I need that password for my investigation. And I need those books kept safe until my genius is recognized, so no. Oh, damn you. What makes you think I want a sticky card? You want a metal strip, then? How about a button? Any more ghosties? Oh, we got two ghosties here. Pratchett. Terry Pratchett and Adams? Adams. Terry Pratchett, though. Oh, hey! Big fan of your work. Officer Dooley says thanks. Not you. Oh. Pratchett won't talk? Damn you, Dooley. Adams? I read your detective books. Wonderfully over the top. Alright, they don't speak. So now we can see the ghost that this kid's talking to, maybe? I think you should read this one. I read this one and thought it was good. Okay, here's that ghosty. And now we can see why the library book is hovering. Enid Blyton. What's it about? It's a story about this kid who can see dead people. I see dead people. Well, it's not for me. I'm scared of ghosts. I fear I find myself in the company of a rather dreadful bunch. Rotters, a lot of them. The kid? No, he's charming. I mean the others. Occultists, horror writers, and DIY fanatics. Horrors, a lot of them. Okay. You want this thing? Alright, let's go. Now what if I try to put this here? I don't have the skills to wire up a normal button, never mind this one. Alright, so we need the ghostie to help. What's all this for? Could you use this button to fix the elevator? I can, but won't do nothing. Needs to be conductive to make circuit work. Ah, okay. This should make the button conductive. Conductive button. This button can now conduct electricity. Sweet. Would you like this card, though? Could this button replace the broken one in the elevator? Let me see. Looks like it'll do job. Gives a few minutes to pop it in place. Okay, you be on your way then. I wonder if this guy has anything else to say about whoever that guy is out there. I met your friend, Yeats. He says you won't stop spying on him.
I find it most joyous to torment the man.
He says you want into that room you mentioned.
I do. I am most bored here. I need something to do, something to read.
Why not use that computer to go online?
Two words. Safe search.
All right, maybe I can find some kind of a workaround?
Please.
Just stay here and don't do anything. So we still don't have the password. Alright, let's go to the horror section then.
Thanks for fixing the elevator, Gale.
Happy to help.
It were fun doing summit useful gain. Useful again?
I don't know. Fourth floor.
Oh look, Doris must have finally fixed the elevator button.
No, it was... Never mind. I forgot, he can't see the ghosts.
That's one heck of a view of the city.
I can't see anything through this viewmaster.
I won't tell anyone if you want to take it off.
I will, but not just yet.
Looks like you can get to the roof through here.
Thankfully it's locked. I'd rather not go back out in that storm.
Yeah, especially not four floors up.
Okay, so the horror section is that way. Book cart. A collection of books that don't seem to fit anywhere else in the library, like How to Cook a Dinosaur, if you ever catch one, The Internet and Other Fads, Architecture of the Mind by Sarah Bellum, and MMO Accountancy, Be the Fictional Banker You Always Knew You Were. Any other books? Notice this. Alright, let's go. Do you want this? Let's go to the horror. Edgar Allan Poe says, "You barely make teenage girls whimper, Howie." Oh, Lovecraft? The other one's gotta be Lovecraft with the hairstyle. They call him Howie.
Yep.
Only because they cannot fathom the dread I conjure, Eddie.